Hey guys, and welcome to Parker 5 Kickin' Debt. I just wanted to give you a little preview of what I'm working on for my church. I serve as a ladies ministry leader, and I absolutely love that. And this Friday is our annual mother-daughter slumber party. And this year we got these cute shirts. Our slumber party is called Pinkapalooza, and I am doing a devotional. It's my first time writing one, but it's over Galatians 5, 22, and 23, and it is the fruits of the Spirit. So I picked up everybody's shirts yesterday and just got those ready, and then I've been busy making muffins for breakfast on Saturday. So these are pumpkin spice. And I've got some of them that were already cool in the container. And I'm going to make a like double chocolate muffin that my family likes. And I'm looking for like two more different kinds. So if you have a suggestion of a muffin that I could take for breakfast Saturday morning, leave it down in the comment section below and everything. So something that's easy and, you know, not any odd ingredients that I may or may not be able to find in my small town. So, but, and then I've just been busy doing dishes. That's the second load of, in the dishwasher, because we had a World Series party for the five of us last night, and apparently none of us wanted to clean up because I walked in and it was just like dishes everywhere dirty plates and cups. And so I've been busy cleaning and getting ready. We have the meal tonight that we're serving to our small group. So I got the corn cake made, and then I'm getting ready to make this angel food dessert. So I will show you that here in a minute. So in my bowl, I dumped in just the dry angel food cake mix and a can of apple pie filling. And you can use any type of pie filling for this. And I just got to thinking about using pumpkin pie filling, but then I'm not for sure what I would put, like what sauce over the top. This one I'm doing caramel. I'm going to do a cherry one with chocolate sauce over it for another time. But it's just these two ingredients, and you just stir it up until it's like a batter. Okay, so I have it all stirred up, and now it just looks like normal cake batter. Obviously, it has apple slices in there, but it's amazing. I never would have thought that those two ingredients would make a cake. So you're supposed to put it in like an angel food pan or a butt pan, and I don't have either. So I just use a disposable 9x13, and I like this. The disposable ones for this because they're a little bit taller than a like glass Pyrex 9x13, and this will really rise up in the middle, and then after it's cooled you put the caramel sauce over it, and I just think the other one might make a mess. But I've sprayed it, and if you don't have one of these, check into it. It's a Pampered Chef item, and you just fill it up with oil to that line, and then you just pump the top up and down. It's hard to do with one hand. But then when you take the top off, it's just, it sprays like a can of Pam. And it's, I mean, this thing I maybe was $10. I don't remember. But it's lasted me for years. And you just put whatever oil you want to use. I usually use olive oil. So I have my oven preheating to 350. I'm going to dump my batter into my pan. And then the Angel Food Mix says bake 43 to 50 minutes. Now this is a different time. When I made it over the weekend, I bought name brand Angel Food because I wasn't headed up to Aldi's. And it only told me 30 minutes, and it did not take 30 minutes. It took like 45. So, excuse me. But I'm going to get this bacon for tonight. And then we are having, in the previous vlog, I said we were doing lasagna or Mexican lasagna. I nixed those plans, and we are doing Chipotle style bowls. So I've got to get the chicken and the hamburger baked up and browned and everything. And then I'll start on the rice later and get my house clean. So Wednesdays are a hectic, crazy day for us, but I love having people over and serving them. So it's one of those, it's good, but yet it's just crazy for me, but absolutely love it. Wouldn't want it any other way. So hope you guys are having a great day and, everything. So I'll see you guys on another vlog. So I decided after I ended the vlog that I better show you what the cake looks like when it's done. So here it is, and it drops in the middle, which is great if you have some people that want more caramel sauce than others, because obviously it'll just kind of pool down there and won't be as much caramely around the top layer, or the out layer, whatever. So there it is, and then right before I serve it, I will warm up this half bottle of sauce and pour it over the top. And honestly, the half bottle is probably a little too much. I wasn't paying attention when I poured it over at the hayride, and so the middle was really, really gooey. So maybe just like a third of the bottle would work, so then you can get three cakes out of this. But everybody loved it at the hayride bonfire that our church had on Sunday. So hopefully they'll like it again tonight. And thanks to Christine at Dead is Dumb for posting this recipe. I think it was last week, but it is going to be a new favorite because it's so easy and simple and so many different flavors you can go with it. So there you go. Hope you guys have a great day.